In one of my last videos I modeled everything, in this one I modeled nothing but the basic shape of the gas station. But I still got a render with a lot of details. How? This video is sponsored by Squarespace, more about that later. Creating a fully CGI scene is a fun process, but also time consuming and requests a lot of skills to make everything look realistic. From modeling or finding models, texturing, lighting, post-processing, etc. But what if you already have a photo or video that is perfectly realistic and we just want to extend it? That can be a shortcut to realism. In this tutorial, we will talk about exactly that. How to extend a photo with 3D elements in free program Blender. I found this frame on Frame Setup, a movie scene search application. I found out later that this frame is from a video for the association Sick Kids Get Better Gifts, where you can buy gifts for sick children or donate to the work of the hospital. You can find the link to the video and the link of the association below. In Photoshop, I removed the actor and the car with the help of Content Aware Fill. New AI tools will probably do a better job, but this is also fine for what I need. I can hide the bad parts with fog later. First, we need to set a photo as a background image. We can do this in the camera settings, but this way we will have a hard time to match the perspective of the photo and the parameters of the camera. The free tool F-Spy can help us with this. F-Spy calculates the approximate focal length, orientation and position of the camera in 3D space based on the user-defined control points in the photo. Now that the camera perspective matches the background photo, I start with ground and character. For the character, I use a CC0 model from PlanSwap. Later I can replace it with another model. I found a pose I like on Mixam. If you now press F12, we will get only 3D models, but without background photo. To fix this, we need to set transparent background and add a background photo with alpha over node in the compositor. If you change the resolution of the render, the background image may not match. Scale and render size solves the problem. Now we have several options what to do with the ground. I can add an asphalt texture to the ground, but that wouldn't fit with the background image and I would have a hard time to match the texture to the rest of the scene later. Everything can easily become unrealistic there. A better option is to project the background photo on the ground from the camera angle using the UV project modifier. In order for UV project to work properly, it is necessary to adjust the image resolution and add more mesh. We now have a ground texture that matches the environment perfectly. If we don't move the camera, we won't notice the stretched texture. But now we have a problem. The photo already have built-in light, reflections and shadows, and as such are perfectly realistic. Later when I add lighting, that means I have double lighting, reflections and shadows. I can fix this if I remove specular, but later I will want to add reflections to the ground, so I will need specular. But I don't have to plan to do animation and move the camera, so I don't need the ground at all, so I will place the ground plane as shadow catcher. In this way, the object is only a shadow catcher. It is invisible to everything else. Now we have a completely realistic ground and shadow of the character or any object on the ground. But the shadow is barely visible and doesn't match the rest of the scene. This is because the lighting creates shadows and our lighting doesn't match the one in the photo. In fact, the only light we have right now is the world light that comes from all directions. Before we continue with the tutorial, let's talk about Squarespace. Before I started with Blender, I did websites. At first I used HTML, later it became simpler using CMS systems, but still reserved only for webmasters, but now it's not like that anymore. Squarespace is a super easy to use thanks to their Fluid Engine, which is a next generation design system that requires no coding skills. I was surprised by the large number of predefinited options. From a large selection of templates sorted by category that are fully customizable, there are also a large number of options for creating online store and business, as well as some marketing tools such as email campaigns, mailing lists, integration with social networks, analytics or SEO tools. Head to squarespace.com/simebulgaria to save 10% of your first purchase of a website or domain using code SIMEBULGARIA. In order to know where to place lighting in 3D space, I modeled the gas station and placed the lighting following the reference photo. Now we have realistic lighting that creates realistic shadows. Shadows can be highlighted with the help of Shadow Catcher Pass. To make the shadows even more dramatic, I added few more lights closer to the ground. Because of the shadows, the character looks as if he is standing on the ground, but we can notice that he doesn't not fit in the environment very well. At first, we see that the black levels do not match and the rendering part is sharp compared to the background. We can fix this easily with the help of an alpha pass that separates the render part from the background photo. I added a little blur to the render. The black colors on the background are washed out, while they are almost completely black on the render. If you want to be more precise, you can use the eyedropper tool to see the brightness percentage of the darker part of both render and background. The render appears to be about 5% darker. Now I can simply add 5% white color to the render part. Since the gas station is of low resolution and compared to the character, it looks a bit like a 2D image, I decide to turn it into a 3D object using the UV project modifier. I added concrete texture in roughness, bump and a bit in color input. Now we have a lot more details because of the high resolution image. I can also control how much reflection I want in the ceiling, which makes the render much more interesting. I want to add the same shiny part to the floor. You can see that detail on a lot of cinematic renders. A reflection floor is a great way to make the rendering more interesting, dramatic, and I put a lot of focus on the character. Since the floor is only a shadow catcher and it's not visible, I only need a glossy direction pass. I duplicated the floor, removed the shadow catcher and used this texture from textures.com in the roughness input. I made a render with F12, but I only saved the glossy direction pass. After that, I removed the ground from the render because I don't need it anymore. Now I can use Glossy Direction Pass as overlay with screen blending mode. With the ellipse mask, color ramp and blur node, I can control where and how much reflection I want. Fog overlays are from this YouTube channel, find link in the description. Now we are mostly done with Blender. We can replace the character with another 3D model, do color correction and add some effects, and that's mostly it. This is a short tutorial. The whole step-by-step tutorial listing 2 hours and 15 minutes can be found on Patreon link in the description or by clicking on YouTube join link, as well as my other tutorials listing more than 60 hours and project files. If you like this video, please click like and subscribe. This helps others find the video. Thank you.